In previous lectures, we have seen you can group elements by selecting them and choose group. You can move and scale a group like it is one object. We have also seen you can merge objects together using the union operation. Although the union operation is destructive when paths overlap, this is normally what you want. As we see, after the union operation, the original circles are gone. But there also is a non-destructive way of merging overlapping paths, called the compound path. I select these two circles. To make them a compound path, I go to Path, Combine. In the Layers panel, we see, we have merged two paths into a single path. But when I click on the Node tool, I see I still have the two original circles. I select a circle by selecting its nodes. To do this, I hold my mouse above one of the nodes, which then becomes red. Then I hold down Control and scroll forward until all nodes are selected. I can now move the circle. If I click on the Show Transformation Handles icon, the circle can also be scaled. I press the space bar to go to the Select tool. So the compound path gives non-destructive results. But its real power is that it can create holes in shapes. I duplicate a circle and make it smaller. I want the orange circle to punch a hole in the green circle. Because the circles don't overlap, there is no danger of losing geometry, so I don't have to use Combine. With both circles selected, I go to Path, Difference. When I click on the Node tool, I see I still have the two paths. I hold my mouse above a node of the inner circle, press Control, and scroll forward until all nodes are selected. We see I am able to move and scale the inner circle. So why does the inner circle create a hole? With this circle, we can see the path direction. I duplicate it and make it smaller. I go to Path, Difference. Inkscape, like Illustrator, will reverse the path direction, which creates the hole. If I select the inner path and go to Path, Reverse, the inner circle doesn't create a hole anymore, because both paths now go in the same direction. I reverse the path again, and I have a hole. This knowledge can be especially useful when handling text. This text is a single path, so a compound path. If I want to manipulate the letters individually, I can go to Path, Break Apart. We see, however, with this operation, we lost the holes in the letters. To get single letters without this problem, I go to Path, Split Path. Now I have individual letters, and the holes are retained. I have encountered this problem in the past, when opening PDFs containing text in Illustrator. To make the letter E a compound path again, I make sure the larger part is placed behind the cutout path. Then I select both paths. I go to Path, Difference. I will do the same for the O. If you still not get the hole, which I have encountered in the past, select the inner circle. Then go to Path, Reverse.